What's it like time traveling between portals, between here 1680 and 2180?
Very quick.
What's happening in 2180 right now?
It's pretty cool to be able to write the story or tell the story, our history of the revolt, but happening simultaneously in two different time dimensions. Yeah. This allows me to create characters that are sci-fi, and the Pueblo revolt has been swept under the carpet, is not taught in our schools. And what I'm trying to do is to educate the world about what happened to our Pueblo people through art. The characters that are on the screen right now are called the Aeronauts, and the Aeronauts are one of the characters that are the Pueblo people in the future. They're coming back from 2180 to present time and to historic times, and their purpose is to gather designs, songs, ceremonies, shards of pottery, artwork, collect them, take them back to the future, and store them so that while we get to 2180, we still have all our culture, our designs, and our know-how of how to make the Pueblo pottery. And it's ready for us when we get there.
How does clay become a story?
Clay is amazing. You know, clay is therapy, saved my life. And, you know, it's been in our family on our mother's side. All of the people on our mother's side of the family are all potters. So I was raised in a family of potters, and not even knowing that our family were creatives and they were always making art on a daily basis. But the whole magic of the clay helps me express it and to really make sure that the continuation of making Cochiti Pueblo pottery and the idea behind it of all basing it on social commentary stay alive and make sure it doesn't die out.
How does that play into the living character creations?
I've created 19 groups of characters that represent the 19 Pueblos that are still left in New Mexico today. And if you were to think of a storyboard in, say, a feature film, I would not only draw it, but I could create it in 3D, like whether it be in clay, I could sketch it or turn it into photography. So I kind of use that whole aspect, and that really pushed me to pick up all these different mediums that I do work in. Mm-hmm. So it spans like jewelry, clothing, costuming, makeup, hair, film, video, digital artwork, Photoshop, and all, everything fits together. So there's many pieces of the puzzle that all come together and work together to tell that story.
Will you introduce us to some of your characters?
Maybe? Yeah, this one is called The Master and Tix, and this is based on historical pieces from Cochiti from the late 1800s, but all of those pieces were based on social commentary so that when, say, the newly laid railroads that were being brought into New Mexico, they brought more people and more tourists and just people in general. So with that brought shows, entertainment like operas or the circus sideshows. So a lot of the historical pieces from Cochiti, you'll see that they have the Siamese twins, the tattooed bodies, anything that you'll see in an old-fashioned circus, right? So I'm reviving that kind of piece, that style here, but this cool Siamese twin would need some pets. So that's how I came up with the ticks. So just always working with the clay while, you know, I usually pray when I'm meditating or making the pieces. And you know, thinking of all our past ancestors who were potters and touched the clay and how it helped them as well, the same thing it's doing for any potter today, trying to make that connection between the past and now. And hope, I mean, obviously when I'm out of here, you know, it's going to be the next, it'll be into the future.
Who are some of the standout individuals in the Pueblo Revolt of the future?
Yeah, there's like I said, there are 19 different groups of characters. Mm-hmm. So like the Aeronauts you see, and then also like what we have here, the Recons. The Watchmen are stationed around Earth's realm and they're positioned there, and they're always looking out for any advancements from the invaders. So basically the revolt happening in the future as well. So any of the invaders coming, they're there to make sure that they don't get past a certain point to the Pueblo people on Earth. And the Recons are doing the same thing, getting reconnaissance about any kind of advancements.
I'm intrigued by Tahu.
Yeah.
Would you talk to us a little bit about that particular character?
Yeah, that was one of the main characters that I created to be the sidekick to Popeye, the original person that devised a plan for the Pueblo Revolt. He was out of Oquehuenque Pueblo, which is north of Santa Fe, and he devised a plan of how to pull off the revolt, which meant that he sent runners from the northern Pueblos to the southern Pueblos. They were all carrying knotted cords, whether it be yucca or leather, and they were instructed to drop off these cords at every Pueblo to the southern Pueblos. So every morning they untied one knot. When all the knots were untied, the entire Pueblo community raised up and they pushed out the invaders. Da'u, that's what like the grandmothers and the granddaughters address each other in Pueblo. And I just wanted to create a character for women empowerment and to give the not only the Pueblo girls a superhero, but to really pay homage to how, you know, the amount of work that our women do in the Pueblos. And you know, it's just, it's, they need like that kind of a strong character.
Yeah.
Da'u is our heroine for the 1680-2180 Pueblo Revolt series. The piece that's on the screen right now, I was able to work with vets that have PTSD. So we worked with clay and we worked with painting. And I designed this piece because I was listening to their stories of how, when they got back from war and how they felt like two people being pulled into directions all the time. So that's how that piece came with the three eyes in it.
Does this particular character relate back to the larger universe?
It is. It's the character called Translator. And oh. Translator, if you think about it, it's kind of like a Yoda figure. So he's the one that helps communicate with all of the future and the past and the present characters that are pulling off the Pueblo Revolt. So he connects everybody, and he's one of the main central characters of my storyline.
Pueblo pottery, or Cochiti pottery specifically, is social commentary.
Mm-hmm.
What are you commenting on now?
Yeah, I mean, that I got lucky at that as well, just
okay.
Because like a lot of people don't know about these historical pieces all based on social commentary. So some people are like, okay, you're like creating these really crazy characters, but that allows me to educate of what I'm doing.
Yeah.
And it's basically reviving the pieces from the 1800s, talking about any subject. And the only thing that has changed is time. So I'm still using, in my traditional work, the same methods and materials as our ancestors did, but also addressing today's hot topics or subjects, whether it be politics or, you know, the LGBTQ community, anything. Subjects that are really hard to discuss, but if you have a piece of artwork in front of you, you're able to discuss it. Subjects like cancer, and it has touched our family. It took both our parents and our sister. Mm-hmm. But to be able to have a piece that is designed around the subject of cancer, you're able to really communicate and get in touch with other families that have gone through the same thing. We had displayed it in a gallery in Scottsdale, and a group of women came in, like maybe say 17 people. They came specifically to see it when we debuted it, and they didn't tell me at first, but after they looked at it, then they knew the backstory of it, but it turned out that they were all cancer survivors. Mm. So they shared their stories with my family. So that connected us that way. But again, it's therapy as mm. well. Like, you know, clay is here for all of us, and it will take care of us.
What drives you to create, Virgil?
Something from up there. I don't know. It always has been there since I was a kid. And I'm very lucky that, you know, I didn't go to school for anything. I had the best professors, which was our family, our mom, our dad, or you know, our grandmother, our cousins, you know, all of them do artwork as well. Back when I was 7 years old, like viewing Star Wars, the original one, and Star Trek and Battlestar Galactica, right?
Mm-hmm.
It helped me look at the future, and it's doing the same thing for me now in this, of how to be more aware and the subject matter that I'm creating.
Yeah.
to the future, and hopefully finding a way of how to resolve any problems or create prayers and ways to help what we're going through right now. So, you know, growing up, I mean, it helped me through life. You know, I didn't have to spend money on a therapist. So, you know, this is what it's here for. And I hope that I'm able to make that connection. And that's what I feel that my participation in Kojiti is to hopefully keep this tradition alive.